Good day, everybody. For those of you that are new here, welcome. For everybody else, welcome back. We're going to create a composite today using Affinity Photo, and we're going to create that geometric 3D shape into our picture here. So as usual, let's get started. Okay, so the first thing we'll do is come over to the picture of the hole here in the road, and this will be available for you in the description to download. Let's hit Command C. Come back over to our picture here and Command V. Let's make sure we grab our move tool here and let's just move that into the middle of the road here. It'll snap, as you can see, we've got snapping turned on. And let's make that a little bit bigger. And just like position it pretty good about there. Let's zoom in. I'm going to use my Command Plus to zoom in a little bit. Hold my Shift key down and then just bring that up a little bit so we can see it a bit better. I'm going to add a mask to this layer here so we can just clean that up a little bit. So we'll click on our mask here to add a mask. Make sure we're clicked on the mask. Let's grab our paintbrush tool. Let's make sure the opacity and the flow are at 100% and that we're painting in black. Going to make my brush a little bit bigger, and then we can just clean up these areas around that were left over when I created this picture. Okay, so I also want to clean up around the edges, so I'm going to make my brush quite small. I'm just going to go around the edges and clean up those edges a little bit as well. So I will speed this up a little bit. Okay, once you're happy with the way that looks, Command Zero, and we're going to collapse that layer. The only other thing we'll do on this layer here is add an effects. So we'll come down here to Layer Effects, and let's click on Outer Shadow, and take that radius all the way up. So it just lets it blend in a little bit more with that outer shadow. We'll just have a look. There we go. Just putting that outer shadow to make it look a little bit better. It's time to add our geometric shape now. So we'll come over here to this layer here. Also created this picture for you, which will be available in the downloads as well. It'll take you to my Dropbox site. All you need to do is come up here to this arrow here and hit download. You don't have to sign in or sign up. You just have to hit the download link over here. Okay, so Command C, back to our original picture, and Command V. Back over to our move tool again. Let's move this into the middle. Let's turn the opacity down a little bit so we can see all the way through. I'm going to make the picture a little bit smaller now, so Command minus, and I'm just going to resize it, make it a little bit bigger. And we can always adjust this size a little bit later as well. So let's make that a little bit bigger now with our Command plus, maybe one more, bring it down so we can trace around the edges. So we're on our picture of our triangle here. We're going to come over here to our pen tool. The only thing we need here is to have it in pen mode. So our stroke, we have no stroke, and we're going to fill this in as we go. So going to turn snapping off so we don't have those lines, and let's start tracing around. So I'm going to start right on the bottom here, just one click, and up to the corner here and click again, and to this one, and click again. So let's go all the way around and come up to fill now up here. I'm going to click on my swatches, click on black, and you can see it's added that layer here as a curves. Let's do the second one now. So we'll start in this corner, and again we're just going all the way around to create the three sides. Come up to here on fill, swatches, and black. Got our next triangle layer here. Let's do our last one on the corner, all the way around the triangle. Click on fill, swatches, and black. We now should have three triangles in our layers here. So three curved layers and three triangles. You need to adjust any of these layers here. You can come over to the pen tool, this little arrow, and come to your node tool. And it'll give you the option that you can then move these little nodes around if you need to. So come back to our pen tool and we'll just click on our little hand tool here. So we've got our three curves in place now. We don't need this layer anymore, the picture of the triangle, so we can click on that and let's drop it to the bottom. We can delete it as well if you don't want to leave it here, but we'll just leave it there for now. Okay, the next thing we want to do is hit Command Zero, get that picture back a little bit smaller, and we're going to start filling in all of our sides of the triangle. So we're going to come down here to our original background, click on our original background and Command J. We've got two copies. This copy we're going to drag up to the first triangle and go to our right. And it's going to fill that triangle with that picture. So we'll do that again down to our background, Command J, move it up to our second triangle and to the right. That's going to fill that triangle. And one more time, Command J, move it to our last curved triangle here and to the right. And we've got all of those triangles filled. So now we can move the pictures within the triangle by clicking on the first background here, coming up to our move tool. Now we can just position that wherever we like. So I'm just going to position the picture of the road here a little bit. And then on the second triangle, I'm going to move this one. I'm just going to move that to a bit of blue sky with some clouds in it, maybe about there. And then on a third one here, I'm also going to make it maybe sort of some sky as well. So you can move the pictures to wherever you like. As you can see, this little side here is not quite even. So we can actually click on that side here, just that triangle, come over here to our pen tool and come down to our node tool. We might be able to fix that up a little bit and that should be a bit better. Okay, so we've got that all even now. Now we've created all three sides. We can just collapse all these triangles and the pictures inside them. Let's click on the first one, hold our shift key down and then click on the last one. And then let's hit Command G to group all those triangles together. So while we've got this group here, we're going to come down here to the effects as well, the layer effects, and click on layer effects. I'm going to add an inner shadow. So let's click on inner shadow and then take that radius all the way up. You can see that just gives a little bit of depth to our shape here. Make sure the color here is black as well. So let's click off that one. So now we've created our 3D triangle geometric shape here. Let's just come back to our FX, click on the little FX that we created before. Let's just click on outer glow now, and let's change the outer glow's color to sort of like a sort of bluey, tealy blue, makes it a really good glow. And let's turn that radius up and just have that outer glow on the end there and turn this intensity down a little bit. Just a little bit of a glow on the bottom there. Okay, let's make that picture a little bit smaller. And we're still on the layer here of the group, but we're going to create a shadow for our triangle. So I'm going to come over here to my rectangle tool, but drop the little drop box down here. And I'm going to pick a triangle. So let's pick a triangle. Make the picture a little bit smaller again with my command minus. And on my triangle, I want my fill to be black. So I'm going to come up here to fill and click on black. And I'm just going to create a black triangle. I'm going to turn it around and position it. And then just resize it a little bit and position it a little bit more. And just put it right underneath. Clicking that on the center again. So we've got our triangle here. I'm going to drop the opacity to 50%. And then on this triangle that I've just created, I'm going to add a live filter, and it's going to be a Gaussian blur or Gaussian blur. And I'm just going to take that radius up just till I see it starting to blur a little bit, and about 27. And we've created our shadow for our geometric shape. It's time to bring over the person now, our next picture in the composite. So let's come over here to the picture that I've chosen for this, and this picture and also the picture of the landscape are from Unsplash, and both of those pictures will be linked in the description below. I'm going to come up here to my selection brush. I'm going to make the man a little bit bigger. Holding my shift key down, just position him so I can get a better look. And the brush, I'm going to make the brush a little bit bigger with my right and left bracket keys to resize that brush. And I'm going to start selecting our person here. And if you've already seen this before and you're fairly confident with your selections and using the selection brush, you can skip ahead to the next section if you like. And I'll just finish you off selecting my person here. Remember, you can resize your brush to get into those smaller places. and just get the selection all the way around his shoes there. And remember, you can hold your option key down to get these little tight areas here. And if you spill over, you can use your option key to bring that selection back again. Once you're happy with your selection, you can hit refine up here and you can brush over any areas to get a better selection. I might just smooth this by 2 and feather that by 2 as well and hit apply. A couple of little sections here that we need to fix up. And once you're happy with all of your selection, come to the keyboard and Command C, back to our picture and Command V. So we've got our man or our person in the picture here. Before I resize our man here, I'm just going to add a levels. So come down here to adjustments and hit levels. Let's clip that just to the man. And on my levels, I'm just going to bring my blacks up to 5% and my white level here down to 80. Just puts a bit of a glow on the man here. So let's click off our levels. The other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to drop the opacity on our man here down to 90%. That's just a little trick just to make him blend into that background a little bit better. Let's grab our move tool and let's resize our man and place him into our picture here. Place him right on the edge of the hole here. Actually going to put the man, I'm going to grab the layer of the man and I'm actually going to put it behind the geometric shape. And I think that looks about right there. Let's add a shadow. So let's grab our new pixel layer and let's bring that pixel layer underneath the man. So the shadow's underneath. Let's come to our paintbrush tool. Let's turn our opacity and flow up to 100%. Make sure we've got our black here, and let's make our brush a little bit bigger. So let's come over to the man's feet, make the brush about that size, and just click once. So we've got that black dot there. Let's grab our move tool, and I'm just going to stretch that out a little bit. And just turn that a little bit right on there. Just stretch it out, maybe a little bit thicker, and click on our hand tool again. So once you've got your shadow positioned, we might just drop the opacity a tiny little bit, maybe to about 85%. So there we have our man and his shadow. Just to finish off now, I'm going to add one more pixel layer on top of the man here. I'm going to grab my color picker and just pick this blue color that we've got on the glow of our shape and activate that blue. Make sure on our brush tool, nice soft brush, make sure our color's activated. I'm going to turn the opacity and the flow down to 50%. I'm going to zoom in a little bit, I'm going to move the pixel layer behind the man as well. And just on behind, I'm just going to add a little bit of glow just around the edge there. Might turn that down a little bit, about 75. And then just one last right on the man here, I might drop the opacity down to 20 and the flow down to 20. We'll have a little bit of a blue glow on his face. Let's hit Command 0 on our keyboard. So there we go, everybody. That's how you create that geometric triangle 3D shape in Affinity Photo. I hope you have enjoyed the tutorial this week. If you have, please give me a thumbs up. Please subscribe to my channel. Until next time, I'll say to you, stay well, stay safe. I'll see you in the next video.